Cathy Salimbangon.
So nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Gerardo Jimenez. I've always wondered about acai berry because I see it and I read about it. So it's so nice to meet the people who brought it here. Why was it acai berry?
That's because of our experience abroad. We used to run a nursing home. It's a 100-bed facility. I'm in charge of the nursing department, and then my husband is the admin. When we were there, I really noticed that yung mga sakit sa matanda is really related to their lifestyle when they were young. Nakita ko na maybe if there's a way we can do something preventive, not just the curative aspect, kasi mahirap na pag nandun na eh. I also realized personally that a lot of medications, even the safest one, long-term use is destructive to your liver and kidney. So it has to be preventive.
I'm fascinated on one is yung that you would think na preventive than curative dahil hindi kadalasan ganyan mag-isip, eh, di ba? Then second is suddenly, you had this opportunity to operate a business, di ba?
Yes.
From, I suppose, your orientation that time was to work as professional. So that was quite a step for you.
I grew up, in our discussions at table namin, it's all about business. My father is a self-made man. And he taught me na you only work for two years. Just to know the ropes, you know, to be an employee. So that when you are in that position, you know how it feels to be an employee. But I think there's a reason for everything. You might not realize it early on, but now, alam ko na, okay, ganito pala. That's why I'm in that industry, I'm that experience, because for me to be equipped with all the knowledge for our business ngayon. But I've heard you are running a organic farm, right?
Well, yes. The methods we observe in growing the produce in the farm is all chemical-free. We don't use any chemical inputs. Actually, I was gardening ever since I was small. Looking back, it was really a sense of wonder. Tatanim ka ng buto, and after a few days, sumisibol na. That was the fascination I had, you know. When we got married, after a few years, we moved to our new house sa Santa Rosa. Yung bahay namin, walang katabing bahay. So, puro empty lot sa tabi. So, nagsimula kami magtanim ng wife ko. Tanim kami ng lechugas, tanim kami ng mga basil. And yun ang naging parang weekend activity namin ng wife ko. No? Shortly after, nalaman namin na yung mga anak namin predisposed sa diabetes. So, sabi namin, this hobby becomes more important to us. So, it's a way for us to alter the diet din ng anak namin. Yeah. So, suddenly we said, itong mga gulay na to, we'll incorporate it more in our family diet. So, ako para, just for that, it's already worth it.
Yeah,
you know?
That's true. So,
after more than a year, you know, parang anong gagawin
dami
natin
na,
dito?
No?
And then we got a chance to sell it in a weekend market. The first experience we had pa in a weekend market, sinubukan namin sa isang market na nagsisimula pa lang. So, wala pang clientele. So, we really prepared all the stuff. Ganda-ganda ng preparasyon. Wala kaming benta ni isa for that whole morning. But my wife and I believed so much in what we're doing. Tsaka nandun na yung produkto.
Exactly.
We found a nearby market na nasubukan ulit. And that's when we started to see na very modest yung reaction ng mga tao. Pero may bilis sila. And then the few people who would buy, tuwan-tuwa naman. So, sabi, syempre na ginanahan kami. And going back to my childhood, nung bata kasi ako, you'd read gardening books. Tapos lagi nga may section on, you use this insecticide against this insect. Ganun. And I even tried it when I was small. Pero naalala ko, takot ako dahil lahat nakalagay poison. It's a poison. And we were feeding it to our children. We were giving it to our families. We were eating it ourselves. So sabi ko, if I'm going to farm with chemicals, I'd rather not farm at all. It doesn't make sense to
me. That's true.
And the more we learned about the effects on the environment, sabi, I mean, this is the way to do it. And it's the least way to harm the environment. In fact, you can enhance the environment with natural methods. You will produce healthy produce talaga.
And I think it's a good business practice because hindi ka lang just for the sake of making money, but there's an advocacy on it. But it's a challenging task for the business owner because you have a principle and a standard to meet. But that would make your business last because more than the profit, you're looking at helping the community.
I'm curious kasi you talked about health being more preventive than curative, and then you chose acai berry. I understand acai berry is something that grows
in the
specifically
Amazon,
in the Amazon.
Lang.
So that presents some challenges in terms of sourcing.
When you said there's a lot of challenges in your business, our business is the same as well. We could have picked other fruits to sell, di ba, or to market, but after our work experience in that nursing home, so we went to LA, and then my husband used to work in a nutraceutical manufacturing company. Then it dawned on us na, okay, we have this expert of people because they have research and development team. So why don't we ask them what's the healthiest fruit or whatever it's there that can help us on our advocacy na talagang going for preventive. And all of them were saying this acai berry is the top superfood in the world. When we came back here, we shipped 3 different kinds of superfood. I tested it to my friends. In acai, 10 minutes, they feel...
10 minutes?
10 minutes. Whoa. They feel decongested.
Almost immediately.
Almost immediately, because that's what the Amazonians are using. Walang hospital doon, it's all forest. And then it's Amazon River. So when they're sick, they have to utilize whatever is in the forest, diba? It helps also the natives in Brazil, their livelihood, because it's a big industry in the Amazon jungle right now. The trees has been there, the palm trees has been there for centuries. So when it's harvest time, they have to climb it.
You mentioned palm trees. It's a
palm tree. It's the tallest palm tree in the Amazon rainforest. 6 months, it's flooded. So that tree has to create a compensatory mechanism to survive. Because it's so tall na yung leaves niya is exposed and sa sun, but yung trunk niya is under the water. So the tree created this antioxidant, which is found in their fruit.
That's fascinating. This is the first time I heard about.
Yes, but I tried it before we went to the market. Because I'm a nurse, so I want it na talagang effective, di ba? Iba yung marinig mo, iba yung actual na makita mo. Because I'm telling you, this is not a cheap supplement. It has to have that effect, di ba? And we've been in the market for 10 years. So I've heard you're a painter. How do you merge or marry being a businessman and at the same time a painter?
I think sa akin, it's not that different.
Yeah.
Nagpasok naman talaga sa akin dito is really this sense of wonder with plants, how they grow from nothing, suddenly malaki. And both things, gardening and painting, art, were part of me kahit nung bata pa ako. You know? Before, I just like to draw at lahat. But I think when I went back to it in my adult years, it was really also a sense of wonder of what was around. You know? Natutuwa ka dahil sa even the simplest plant, the simplest leaf. And in my art, that's also what I get. Ano? Something as ordinary as a cup of coffee. When you try to draw it, bigla nakikita mo, maganda pala siya. And then, while I was doing the farming, the business, I went back to art. And then, just like before, parang napapansin ko, I was getting pulled more into the art. Ano? And I think it reached the point na I realized for myself that this is my calling. Kung calling ko dati was the farming, parang the art was my calling at this point in my life. Ano? So sabi ko, hindi ko matalikuran yun. So when I realized that, our first decision was, we go all out for it. No? Tigil na natin yung farm. And right before we were going to end already the farm, my wife and we decided she wanted to run it. It turned out to be the best thing, I think, for us to do. Dahil una, sayang naman yung farm. And then I could still do the art. I think one thing we realized also was agri is such a good thing for the country. If we develop our agri, it's really good for us. And there's a lot of potential in agri as a business, as an industry. But it's also one of the most difficult. Wala kang inventory. It's all in the field. Production, productivity changes with the weather. You have all these risks. Market, weather, mahirap siya, no?
Especially I, if you're talking about organic farm, no?
And then if you do it pa organic farming wise, no shortcuts, it's even more challenging. I think this demands also the best people to do it. So we want to do something also in terms of hopefully promoting also communicating our love for it to children, to students.
Oh,
and hopefully they would also be inspired to at least look at it as a possibility in their life. But also second, for people to value the work of farmers. Ano. May iba naman ako, in my case, ganun. Kayo, you've attained quite a lot of success with acai berries. Ano. Ngayon, what's keeping you going or what else
going?
Do you want to accomplish?
Actually, we barely scratched the surface sa market. And that keeps me going. Kasi I know that we've been selling thousands of bottles per month, but then a lot of people, ilang millions ang kailangan. So you barely scratch the surface there. So that keeps us going. When I work in a nursing home or in a hospital, I have a limited 8 hours now. So I can only attend to 8 patients. But with this product, it make me and make us cater to thousands of people at the same time. So it's really fulfilling. The good effect that our product had with their customers, they were able to live their life fully. They were able to get up, spend time with their family, work, be productive because of our product. And they're the one telling us, we really want to celebrate life. And through our product, we were able to do it. So I really thank God for making us an instrument. Now, through our skill that he gave us, we were able to bring this acai berry to the table of the family of an individual who needs this product.
Yeah. Ganda. It's so nice the way you put it. Ano? In our case, we're sa Malipayon Farms. We've seen the joy people have when they visit the farm. Diba?
Yeah.
We'd like to extend that some more.
Yeah.
We'd like to communicate that some more, not just to our restaurant clients, but also to especially the youth, the people who'd like to know more about gardening or farming, you know. And I think that's also to communicate that joy, that sense of wonder is also what I have in the art part, you know. That's what keeps me
going.
For me to show light in your paintings is for me to show also our creator.
Yeah.
The faith is very much a part of it. As an artist and also as part of Malipayon Farms, as husband to my wife who's now running it, that's my direction.
And I think the dedication that you put into your farm and also your art, that also inspires a lot of people, diba? And because you really want to help, you really want to put out the best product there is for your customers. I think that's a very noble thing to do.
Thank you. Same with you.
Yeah.